the world is at war. And in this documentary, you will see it through the eyes of the men and women who wage it in the name of freedom and democracy. Modern technologies have outfitted many of these soldiers with equipment that not only feeds them important information of the battlefield, but also records what they see. You will literally get a first-person view of war. Having stated this, you must know viewer discretion is strongly advised. War is gruesome, confusing, loud, and violent. And this documentary aims to capture just that.
My name is Lieutenant Charles Hawkins, callsign Wedge. I'm a naval flight officer, responsible for manning the weapon systems of an FA-18 Super Hornet. My pilot is Nick Hobby McCauley. Such Star Wars nerds. I grew up in a small town on the Oregon and California border called New Pine Creek. We lived on the Oregon side. New Pine Creek is a town with a population of less than 300. A picture-perfect small-town America. Not exactly the type of place you might expect to find a man like Lieutenant Hawkins. The town boasts its own small general store, post office, and a one-room school. But most of the population commutes 14 miles north to the town of Lakeview for their work, their schooling, and most of their shopping. Lakeview is in itself a picturesque scene of old-time America. I love that little community. It's where I met my wife. It's where we married. It's where our daughter was born. It's home. It's all I could think about. It's all I wanted. I'll never be able to look at February 14th the same ever again. Lieutenant Hawkins was stationed on the aircraft carrier Essex, which was deployed in the Gulf of Oman. Strategically placed on the borders of Pakistan, Iran, and Oman, Lieutenant Hawkins saw lots of flight and mission time. On February 14, 2015, Lieutenant Hawkins and his squadron were assigned to fly air support for a detachment of Marines as they took control of an oil refinery in Iran. This was the deepest into enemy airspace the young lieutenant had ever ventured. And it would be a day far beyond imagining for the small town pilot.
Okay, let's rock and roll.
Let's do this!
was merely a routine mission. Just flyer support for the Marines taking over a Russian occupied oil refinery in Iran. It was Valentine's Day. And I had a phone date with Cassandra, and I wasn't gonna miss it. A little wheeling and dealing, and a lot of extra work for that phone call. This was different. It's not like the days of Desert Storm and Operation Enduring Freedom. These Russian pilots are good. He got careless. He came in fast. By the time our radar was picked up, we only had time. It was too late. after being intercepted and watching her good friends die. Wedge and Harvey still had the rendezvous with the Lyrian detachment. They still had a mission to complete. There's nothing anybody could do. That's just a matter of statistics. I knew Hoppy didn't make it. That was our planet when burning by. He was still in the cockpit. Just had to get back home. And get back to Cassandra. At least get back to the aircraft carrier over a phone call. I saw the Jeep. I took it. And I hit it right for me. I just got the hell out of there. After a quick debriefing, I loaded up on a Huey, headed back to the aircraft carrier. Should have been easy. Shot down for the second time in one day. Unbelievable. When my boots hit the ground, man, all I could think about was I gotta get back to that stupid base. But you know what? I was gonna do as much damage as I could on my way back there. It was the first time I'd ever shot someone. It's the first time I really thought about killing someone in combat. It's the first time it was personal. It made things real. It made me realize this isn't a game. I gotta get back to Sandra. She's at home. Pregnant with my unborn child. I really need to get back home.
After I was sure that enemy armor had cleared the area, I was out there.
Lieutenant Hawkins made his way back to the Marine forward operating base. It was there he learned his day was not quite over. The Russians had launched a counterattack upon the aircraft carrier Essex. He was to return to his ship and hope to defend. Not a bad start to a day, huh?